It's train sim world, folks. West world. Is that what I ordered?
You've been called in to cover for a driver who's been delayed on another service. You're needed to take the train out to Reading, where the driver will continue the service as scheduled. Head into London Paddington to pick up the train. Be sure to arrive no later than 19:20.
Well, I quite like that, so... What, I have to get on the train. Okay, I have to get on as a passenger. Okay, fine, I can do that. Where is this going? Where I want? Or where do I have to go? Paddington. Right. Is this going to Paddington? Are you going to Paddington? Sorry, myself. That's not how you catch a train. That's how you catch death. Where is this going? We're at Ealing Broadway. I know nothing about London and its railways. Like where things are. Well, it must be, otherwise it wouldn't be telling me to get on it. Let's get on. Oh, it's the beeping at me, jeez. Oh, I want to get off. How dare you? Okay, so where did you come from? Where are you coming from? Stop spawning midair at me. It's very rude. Is your mother teaching you to spawn at people randomly? Good lord. Right, so that's not a seat. Oh, okay. I can sit here. That's standard class, but that's for lowborn fools. Where's first class? Gotta get in first class, right? Yeah. Oh. How do I can't. Oh, you can only open the door from that's nonsense. Hello. I believe you're in my seat. Dear boy. Well, now you've gone, haven't you? Well, no, you haven't. Aha! Damn it! I have to sit on his knee. Aha! Oh! Balls. Now I have to be all British about it. Excuse me. Yeah, this. No, I need to. Oh, I can't get in this. Oh, sod. I'm gonna hide from the ticket man now. Where's first class? That's standard class, and that's... What's that? Oh, I can go in. Ooh. Special. Oh, sitting there out. No, I'm not allowed to drive. Well, I guess it's already being driven, so that makes sense. That's where I've just been. And there are mini switches where I can't drive the train, but I can unlock the train and hit the emergency brake. Do I dare? No, because then I probably won't get there before the time I need to get there before, will I? I need to get there by 20 past 7 and it's now 3 minutes past it. That's real time as well. So it's going to take, what, 17 actual minutes to get there. Good lord. I can't even open the door. I mean, I guess it's safer that way because we're moving at all, but... Close that. So where's first class? There's a standard class. It stands to reason there should be a first class. Otherwise it wouldn't be standard class. There's no point in having it. That's just unnerving. There's no point in having a standard class if you're not also then going to have a first class to look down their noses at you, right? What if you were down the other end of the train wearing a different coat. Look, you're just all over this train wearing different coats. It's just like the voyage of the damned. Standard class. Ah, first class. You can tell it's first class because of the leather. So now I'm privileged. Do you look at me like that? I clearly have a right to be here. Don't you judge me. I'll click on your face. Ah, see? Don't like being clicked on, do you? Ah. It's 4 miles away. I wonder if I can get in the... Ooh. Oh, there's the person driving the train. Look, I know hands. Oh, sorry. Sorry, love. Well, there's another station. I can turn his wipers on. That works as well. That's terrifying. Why can I do that? But I can't, you know, drive the train. I can just scare the shit out of everyone on the platform. How are you driving the train whilst not actually, like, changing any of the control positions? Doors open. Is this Paddington? No, this is not Paddington. This is... somewhere else. Where's this? Acton Main Line. Okay. What if the help point works? Help. How do I get to Paddington? I wonder if he'll go without me. It's very likely. All the doors are open. Ooh, let's have a quick smoke in here. Right, let's quick back, let's get back on before he does actually go without me. I can shut the doors. Can I? Yes. Aha. That makes it go faster. I'm a terrible passenger. I would never dream of doing this in real life. You'd always sit in these seats because you get the legroom and the little table. I get my laptop out on this little table. It's still ages away. I mean, I'm obviously going to have to fast forward most of this because it's just not like workable footage, but I like the fact this is part of the game. Maybe I'll keep it in because it is, you know, at the same time as what I wanted from this game was for it to be something where you can, to some degree of realism at least, you can travel on this rail network as a passenger. I understand this is a, a contrived service that happens to be going there at the right time, but I could see this being a realistic scenario. You know, I'm going from where I live to where I need to be to get the train, to take the train to where it needs to be because the bloke's been held up. What was the situation? He's been delayed on another service, so I need to take the train out to Reading, which looks like Reading, but you say Reading. So I'm now here. There's all that line behind me that I won't use. I can't read that in the slightest. Where's Reading? Oh, it's this way. Okay. So I'm being sent over to here. Oh, has it gone? That's where we're landing, I guess. Maybe one of these trains is my train. I don't know. Ooh. There's a book. That's Paddington then. Where's Reading? There's no labels on anything. Looks like a long strand of spaghetti. Maybe that's Reading. Considering it's the other end of the line. Alright, admittedly the line would continue further on, but I have no time for these trivialities. What was that? I can't do anything but that. Anyway. We're not actually moving while I do that, so this just makes everything take longer. How dare you look at the map. Yeah, this is about as monotonous as being a passenger on a train actually is. This is why, you know, all these people clearly have found something else to do, whether it's to listen to music or read the paper or stare blankly at the seat in front of you whilst slowly turning your head from side to side, because that seems to be what everyone wants to do. Well, this person's looking out the window, at least, or they were. Now they're, again, staring at the seat in front of them and giving me a judgmental
kind of look.
That's not a standard class seat. That's, you know, if I sit in it, I go here. I don't think I really hate sitting backwards on a train. It's not nice. Hopefully I've fixed my levels since the previous video and you can hear me this time, but it's train sim world, so hopefully for a bit of footage I'll actually use. What can I say about this game so far? So this isn't my first go, obviously. I did a few of these to prove to myself that it worked, to see what the game was like, whether I would want to make a video of it, whether it would be something that I would enjoy, and it's got trains in it, and you can drive the trains. The trains are somewhat realistic, I would say. There's been an attempt. So one of the things that I really like is realism, is a simulation, and that is clearly what it strives to be. This kind of situation where, you know, the something else is driving the train, everything's happening around me, definitely okay with that. Big on the idea that the world will carry on in my absence, and that's what I love about games like Subnautica. You never feel like it's player-centric. It never really should be, because, let's face it, the world isn't player-centric at all. So you're left with the notion that, you know, any of these lines could hold a train at any moment, that this is a normal timetable that's being run, and yeah, I can buy into that. I can suspend my disbelief. It's reasonably well done for that regard. I mean, this nonsense about, you know, I can't open this door from the outside, I can just walk through it and then open it from this side, that's not good. And I can see why things like that happen and how they come about, but you know, it only clips me. It only clips me from this side. You know, it's just bizarre, really. And you know, there's part of me that would like it to go further. I'd like to have to put my bag up here, or my bike in here, or you know, sit awkwardly on the luggage rack because it's standing room only. I mean, that probably is the least realistic aspect of all of this, is just how much space there is on this train. You know, alright, it's 7:10 in the evening, and maybe that's, you know, maybe that's okay, but I still feel like there would be more people on the train. Maybe it's configurable, let's see if we can increase the, what would it be under, so this game, I guess it's performance really, isn't it? And I did go through, like I always do, and turn everything up to max. Advanced setting, no, there's not an awful lot to select really. Default movement is walk, so there's, you know, there's something you can turn off the various HUD elements. When we actually get to driving a train, you'll see there are quite a few HUD elements that I don't mind, but I can see, you know, if you wanted a truly authentic experience, you could turn that off. It tries to guide you through what button to press, it tries to guide you to where your next signal will be, and so on and so forth. And you can turn that off, but there's no button to increase the population, the local sort of population of people. I understand why there's not many people there, but if you rig and handle it, then really you should be able to put more people on. So I'm not allowed to drive the train, but I can kind of sit on his shoulders and watch him bring this train in, and it's not very far away. What I'd like to do is to sprint backwards on the train and watch that slow down. And it was speed up as well, the distance away, because it's actually measuring from me and not from the train. So let's sit back in the first class seat and enjoy the approach to Paddington through the window and the baiting reflection of the other side of the train. You know, this is fairly okay, I suppose. You are extremely close to it at this point, but I don't know, I kind of feel like I could have had a bit more fidelity here. Especially the window reflections aren't brilliant. They look sort of grimy, but not like the actual grime that you'd get from it being a railway. Everything's kind of clean, but then not clean at the same time. So, sure. The tables aren't dirty in any way. The wall surfaces aren't dirty. I mean, the carpets look like they've been steamrolled because they're extremely flat. They're not dirty. There's no, you know, there's some kind of obviously repeated patterns of wear, but they're not dirty. Nothing's dirty really. Even the exterior of the train is scrupulously clean, but for the kind of baked-in dirt. Sorry, the kind of baked-in dirt there, and I'm kind of like, you know, I feel like these are things that we can do, but you know, I'm not sure where else that resource budget went. Well, obviously it depends on how low-end machines you want to be able to support, so I've got to follow these markers now and get my actual train, which is fine. Where is it? It's one of those, I think. Excuse me, do you know where my train is? I seem to have... Oh, sorry then. Very unhelpful. I wonder if I can go to the information. No, I can't. That's not entirely surprising, because, you know, that's just the great wide world living out there. That's annoying. I'd got past the point where I needed to be. You could have just let me have that. Right, so it's this side, isn't it? But is it the whole thing? Is it the train? Can I get in here? Yes, I can. Oh, I can open the window as well. That's surprising and slightly unhelpful. so this is a different. This is the dining car, maybe? Am I supposed to be able to be here? That's for. Oh, it's first class. Okay. Oh, it opened for me. Swish. These look very comfortable, I have to say. I'm going the wrong way. I'm going to the wrong end of the train. That won't help me. I can just sort of push my face into these doors and they open. It's the dining car. Which looks, I don't know, almost unfinished, the whiteness of that. I've never been on one of these trains before, but it doesn't look like it's supposed to look like that. She looked unimpressed, didn't she? I mean, the door was open, you could have gone. Let's go trigger the train off and she can get on and stop folding her arms at me. No, that may have been a mistake. Coming in this one may have been a mistake, right, okay. I mean, I've got 15 minutes to kill. And these are actual minutes as well, so this is gonna be like, can I get in here? It's not looks like the service entrance maybe, or the special door, I don't know. And there's the engine, and this is where I've got to go. Okay, I will sit down. Headlights today. And I'll reverse it to forwards. Yeah, because there's no door controls in this, is there? They've unlocked the doors on the left side. There really are no door controls. So all the doors should be open now. And that woman with her arms folded should be gone. Yeah. Sort of suggests you can get in there, but then you can't. There's a whole sort of area that you can't get into on that train. Okay, so we're loading passengers. But I mean, we don't leave for another 13 minutes and 15 seconds. Well, can I open that door? Okay. So, again, I don't mind that. It's what I'm after in the game is the realism. What happens if I throw myself onto the tracks? There's a red, okay? And I can't get off. I have a solution for that. Get in the train. Yeah, so don't do that. I can sit in the seat. I can press all the things from the seat. I can change the climate control to whatever that value means. I can set the fan to fan. I can do those things and turn off the light, which is already off. What's that do? Engine room light. Even though I can't go in the engine room, I can turn the light on in there. It's helpful. One. No. Damn. Okay. I give up. And again, you know, I'm quite close to it, but that's quite low fidelity. I can still read it, but you know, it would have been nice to be able to get in there. I don't know what I would have done in there, but I guess train mechanic simulator is there for that. So, yeah, we've got to wait till 7:30 now. I guess that's what we'll do. I'm not going to subject you to that minute for minute. If I say anything useful, then I'll bring it back. But it's another 12 minutes away, so let's not make you sit through that. Okay, so we've got just over a minute, under a minute now to go before starting the service. I've got about 30 minutes of footage of this game already before the edit, which I haven't even actually started driving the train yet. So it amuses me in a way, just because, well, yeah, I haven't actually started doing the main thing that people might consider the game is actually about, which is driving a train. But I, at the same time, I can see that, you know, what I've just spent the last 10 minutes doing is messing with my phone, or I went and got coffee, which, if I was a train driver in this situation, it's probably exactly what I would have done in real life. So, you know. We've got 10 seconds to go. I can imagine we're going to have to shut the doors soon, so let's pop up the dispatcher menu. Doesn't pause when I do that. And I'm guessing it's going to be a lot left. There you go, all the doors on the left hand side. Double check that that's the case. Yes, I've done it already, thank you. And the doors are locked. Smashing. I need to sit down and I need to do it again because it didn't see me. Move to the park, acknowledge the guard with two presses. Train brake into running. And yes, that's a good buzzing. Puddle to notch one, and let's drive this train. It's already moving. Notch one, it's just slow park station. I mean, you know, I like moving to the control. There's this thing as well, so I don't have to actually like move my whole head to get down there. But most of the time I will just use the keyboard shortcut to adjust the throttle, so it's A and D for that. I did put the lights on, didn't I? Yes, it is. Okay, it's really dark out there. Cab lights are off as well. And they were. Now they're even more off. Maybe I should look where I'm going. That'd be a good idea, wouldn't it? So, speed limit here is, I don't know. Stop at location Reading at 1 minute past 8. So it's going to take me 30 minutes to get there. Okay. Let's have some more speed. Again, I don't know. Oh, the speed. Oh, it's there. It's that red line there on the. Okay. So 40 then. Full throttle. Let's bring it up to speed. Oh, we're definitely going forwards. Let's see how we get on from there. So we're driving the train. I mean, yeah, at this point it kind of feels like the rest of Train Sim did. It's, you know, okay, there's maybe a few more bells and whistles that are realised in the cab, which I always appreciate. But yeah, I mean, it's, you know, we're driving the train, we've got to speed now, I'm coasting the train, which is what you do. It's very much basically Train Simulator, which, yeah, the one breeds from the other, although this is, as I understand it, a ground up rewrite. It's nice driving through London at sunset. There's some graffiti. There's what look like clouds, but, you know, they could just be turds in the sky because they're very flat. There's a cement mixer over there, the endless construction yard that most places in the world seem to be lately. Certainly, most places in this country seem to be. I find it quite hard to see, actually. The sun is at that odd angle where it's difficult to make out what's in front of you. Because of the nature of the light and the angle of the light is And again, this happens in the real world, and sometimes when I drive my car, I find that I can't see where the hell I'm going. But I don't carry on blindly there, I need more speed, don't have to take my eye off. Speed limit's gone up to 50 as well, so I'm already losing time. Which is not like me, normally I have to worry about speeding. As, you know, I'm a speed freak. So, there you go. Wow, 37 miles an hour. I mean, this is a high-speed train as well, so you'd think we'd be going faster. Full speed. We're going downhill, so I'll have to manage for that. If I zoom in, it's a little easier to see what's going on out the window. The field of view is fine. That's it. And then we can idle now. We just kind of spool the throttle to keep it. You've got to press it. It doesn't, a tap on it doesn't do it. Which it did in Train Sim. A little tap on the button was enough, but I've got to actually sort of hold A to make it change anything. So you can probably hear the keyboard when I just tap D. It does nothing, but I've got to hold down for a second and it will register what I want. And I don't mind that, it's not unpleasant, you know, I want to be sure if I'm changing the throttle settings. But, you know, some of it's like, well, maybe it feels more like having used the physical control in the train, but it doesn't feel much like having moved that. It feels much more like I've pressed a key on my keyboard. So, you know, however long I have to press it for, that's what it feels like. Sorry. But that's just the way it is. So, the speed limit's now 100 miles an hour from what I can tell. Which is really going to help, because we've got to go, I need to average a little over 60 miles an hour now to get there in time. And so far I've been below that for almost the entire journey, so I really am going to have to kick it up now. 125 maximum speed limit. So these little floating things, these are the things you can turn off, but honestly, I've missed the speed limit changes with them every time there's been a speed limit change, even with them turned on. That's part because I'm not paying attention, because I'm blinded by the sunlight and these little nifty, you know, I can put my blind down all the way and I can't see where the hell I'm going now. That's really how you do that, but I can. And you can do that in a real train as well, so, you know, you should be able to do that. One of the things that annoys me a lot, if I buy a game, and the Formula One games did this, when they said, oh no, you can't have control of the car in the pit lane, because the first thing you'll do is people will just race through the pit lane and ignore the pit lane speed limit. And I'm like, well, okay, maybe they will. Let them. I bought the game. If I want to do that, I should be able to do that. At no point in real life does some artificial system take control of the car and roll it through the pit lane for you. And it's true in this game, really. If I want to, at this point, leave the throttle wide open and let the train just derail, then I could do. It's not going to stop me. And I appreciate the freedom in that. It's not what you should do. It's not the spirit of the game, by any stretch of the imagination. My headlamp as well. But that is kind of... that is what you should be able to do. No, I've chosen, actually, all things considered, I'd quite like to go and do something different to what I should do. I paid for the game, so why should someone else's decision be more important? I've lost what I was saying in that. But you can turn those little floaty things off if you want to. I'm finding it quite helpful as well, showing me the aspect of the next signal. That's a little bit unrealistic, because obviously in real life you wouldn't have that. So I wouldn't have a chance of knowing that in half a mile the next signal's green until I got to wherever that signal is now that's hiding behind that green marker. Again, I've played train sims with them off, or I've played train sims that don't have them. I've played train sims, this one with them on. I couldn't even see that signal, so if that had gone red, I would have sped it, because I couldn't see it. So, you know, I quite like knowing how far away my destination is going to be. That's going to help me when I come to plan my braking for it, which isn't going to be from 111 miles an hour. Although it's nice that I'm now doing that. Can't open the door. I can still try to open the door, but you can't open it. And in this train, that seems to cut me off from the rest of the train as well. This is the Intercity 125, as was, I think, HST. But the Great Western. The Great Western train's livery upon it. It's fun, actually. In, you know, if you like to pilot trains, which I do, then it's, you know, it's good fun. And there are, you can press all the switches and they do things, although some of them I don't want to press just at this moment, because I'm moving the train at some speed now. Some of them would be potentially disastrous to press. But there is part of me that wonders what might happen if I did press them, because would the disaster that might be, would that suddenly come to pass? Would it happen? Things like the emergency brake, yeah, I can see that would probably happen. Headlight flash, makes the headlights flash. You can't see it from inside. I'm not seeing any real impact of the headlights. Maybe it's that, if I turn them off. No, even that is still there, so the headlights don't seem to have much impact on what you can... I'm speeding. What you can see. This is why it's going yellow. To say that I'm speeding. But only just. I mean, I'm speeding from the design parameters of the train as well. I'm going downhill slightly, so that's to be expected, perhaps, but I should be managing my speed better than that. So it's 23 miles away to Reading. It's going to take, at most, another 20 minutes, probably. I want to ride this all the way there because it's fun, but I don't expect you to stick around for the whole thing. I'll chop and change it. There's a train over there. So, every train game has got other trains that feature in it, and some of them purport to be more intelligent than others. And I remember this, you know, back in 2006 with the trains games, where there was always the claim of a wondrous AI to schedule things and so on and so forth, and we wound up with things like the Dispatcher, which, okay, I understand this function and why it's there, but it's a bit clunky. When everything else in the cab is a real switch or it's a real thing, having something like that doesn't quite feel right, and it does break the immersion, but not very much at the same time. I can get along with it. It's not killing the game for me. It's obviously not the most action-packed thing in the world to do, to drive a train, and I think, you know, on balance, we generally hope that it wouldn't be, because, well, I don't think it's really a positive outcome to drive, the idea of driving a train being action-packed. So that's fine. Somehow I can reach that door handle from all the way over here. It's pretty impressive. So, the other thing with this is that there is a metagame going on with the score, so I've got 4,500 points, and it gives me random points as well for pressing. Let's give me 50 points for pressing that button. But not for pressing that one. Oh, there you go. Is it for pressing the button? Is it for something else? I don't know. But I'm gaining points all the time. And those get added to various scores at the end of the activity. So I'll get a score for this train. I'll get a score for this route, this railway. And then I'll get a score for myself overall. And the three are tracked independently. Really hard to see where I'm going now. just sunset on the rails. I can see kind of the rails, but I can't really see what's in front of me, which is slightly disconcerting. Oh, there's another train. Hello, other train. I'm going faster than you. Nah, 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 nah. I mean, I guess there are people on that as well. So, that's good fun. I'm making good time, I think. It's appreciative when I get there that I brought this train to him. And that he can just, like, you know, carry on with his day if nothing happened. And I have to then somehow get back to where I was. Probably have to get another train. Hell no. This is pretty helpful. I don't know what this is for. I guess maybe for when the guard wants my attention. This is brake pressure. That one is, I don't know. MR. It's not amps. Is it brake pipe pressure? Brake pipe? Master reserve, maybe? Damn. 124 miles per hour. Be there in no time. So if the dark parts are the clouds, or if they're the sky in between the bigger white clouds. Probably not. It doesn't seem to be as harsh at penalising speeding as train sim itself is, but I guess I'll wait till the end, the final score, to really know. Certainly railworks, when it was railworks, it was very keen to dock you for even 1 mile over the limit for not a very long time either. It would start shaving points off. Amp style actually tracking what the amp reading here says. Is it the same thing? As I increase the power. Yes, there you go. More amps. There's a lot of amps. It's nearly 1,000 amps. But there's a lot of power required as well. I guess we're happy with the climate. 6.8 miles to go. We're flying along. Good grief, look at us. Put the cab lights on, it's a bit gloomy. There you go. Lovely. Now I can see the inside of my cab perfectly. But the headlights don't seem to do a thing, do they? Night headlamp. And markers. I think that's what it should be set to, but it doesn't seem to light the way at all. So, maybe I've got that wrong, I don't know. None of the other trains seem to have any headlights either, beyond that, so. I mean, there's obviously tail lights, which is not correct. Yeah, that's not right. Then there's off, which is again, not correct. Markers, which looks kind of like off. Day headlamp, which is the one on the other side. And the night headlamp, which is the one I had, which is theoretically the bright one, but doesn't make any difference. So they're not lighting the way up at all. But we are coming up to a speed limit change, so I best start reducing my speed. It's 2 miles away and I need to shave 30 mph off. At this point, I've got 3 miles to go, and I've got 10 minutes to cover that distance in, so it looks like a reasonable chance of me getting there on time, I would say. I don't want to brake at this point, I just want to gradually slow down. I'm going uphill very slightly, but it doesn't take much off the train at all, does it? Lost 5 a bit, I'm going to have to apply some gentle braking, I think. Let's just let it run on the initial. Brake pipe pressure is very slight. I don't want much. I do want to put on that though. So 95. I'm gonna be speeding. I'm speeding quite a lot. Yes, it's a yellow signal too. That's it. Back to running. Kick some throttle in. And where's the AWS button in this gun? There it is. So I didn't have to acknowledge the yellow signal then. Which I should have done. Need to acknowledge that. Speed limit. Jesus. That's coming up on me. Yeah, I'm gonna blow through that as well. This is not a good approach at all. Because I wasn't paying attention. Oh dear. It's going down even further. So, how not to approach the station with the train. And this is where I need to stop the train as well, and I'm coming in very, very quick. Jeez, this is going to go badly. Full service on the train brake. It's not going to stop me. That's all she got. Signal past the danger. Well, that was a disappointing end, wasn't it? Never mind.